Greetings, FanSplash fans, and welcome to another episode of the FanSplash podcast. This is episode 35, or XXXV.
Right. I think so. Yeah.
Okay. Well, thank you for joining us. As I said, we have a lot of topics to get through. We had a decent movie news week, and we're gonna, you know, I'm repping everything. We got some Marvel and DC. We're gonna be talking about both of them today.
Stand up real quick and show them your sweatshirt.
Okay, this is probably the best purchase I've ever made. Bam, bam. $4.
$4.
$4.
That's crazy.
Thank you, Play-Dohs. Anywho, so we will start out talking about the Bam and the Bam, which with, but not the Boom. We do have Legion of Boom. We got the background blankets, the jersey there in the playoffs.
Fuck the Falcons.
I was literally, those words were about to escape my mouth. Good luck, Seahawks. This is the time to,
man, really get your team spirit going.
Yeah, get it together. Anyways, yes, hopefully you guys are Hawks fans, and yeah, go Hawks this weekend. And what do we know? We don't know yet who they'd be playing after the Falcons, right?
I don't know.
Right, I don't know either. I'm not good with like breaking down the statistics and figuring out like keeping track of the big whole board. I just go week by week. All right. Anyway, so we're gonna kick it off with Justice League. Several days ago, not quite a week ago, they released a new image of the lineup without Superman, which a lot of people are like, oh, why don't they just show him? Well, this looks like it's actually possibly a movie still, whereas everything else seemed to be like Photoshop crap pictures. You know, mm-hmm. This looks like this might actually be them coming out of the Flying Fox ship. That's Batman's cruiser ship that he made for the Justice League in this movie. It's called the Flying Fox.
And everything we've seen so far is, I mean, we've only seen a little bit so far, so it could be just like 10 minutes of the movie.
Sure.
Where it shows him trying to gather the Justice League. That could be just a small chunk of it. But as of now, as of all the things we haven't seen, or have seen rather, there is no Superman. Because
right.
He's still dead.
And I would be very happy and content if he didn't show up until like the last 15 minutes of the movie. Like where Wonder Woman shows up in BVS.
Would Superman be that.
Yeah, exactly.
I was thinking the same thing. That would be nice.
Yeah, I don't need him in the majority. Because we have Justice League 2. Yeah, we can have Superman come in there. This is the team coming together. And nobody's going to seem special if you can just throw Superman at whatever villain you're fighting. So it'll be good to watch some of the smaller characters have to take on Steppenwolf and stuff and have Superman come save the day at the end, or however they want to do it.
It'd be really cool seeing Flash trying to fight him as a new Flash, still getting into his powers, sort of.
Yeah,
and Cyborg, brand new, still figuring himself out.
Speaking of Flash and Cyborg, let's talk about the costume design, because I think that's really, other than Aquaman, that's what's on display here in this image. They put Aquaman in the shadows a little bit, but we can clearly see a lot of the other costumes we haven't had.
You can see a lot of Aquaman, though.
Yeah, you can see that he's got, it's not the shirtless look, it's the full armored look, and he looks like a beast.
Aquaman honestly looks the best out of all of them. Batman, I'm still not digging the goggles.
Well, it's hard to tell in the picture. I can't tell. It looks like they're like flipped or pushed up in this image.
Oh, they're pushed up, I'm pretty sure, but I just don't like them.
I don't love...
What are they for? What's the purpose?
Infrared and like a million different other things. Because unlike the Batman that we know, where he usually has like the white eyes that have technology built into him, we always see Batman's eyes in these new movies, so there's no technology there. He has the goggles to serve as the... You know, the visors.
Right, and it makes sense, which is why but he had the white eyes with his armor suit.
True. I'm with you. I'm not completely sold on the goggles. However, the rest of the tactical bat suit, the armored plates and stuff.
Yeah.
Mixed with the classic look of Batman, I feel like they are doing a better job of what the Dark Knight movies tried to do.
I was just going to say, but it is really, really reminiscent of Dark Knight.
but I think it looks better to me. To me, it looks like the Arkham games Batman, the newer Arkham games.
I'm not saying it looks bad. I think Batman always looks good, usually, but like...
He looks less plastic
really
than Dark Knight.
I really hope we get more of the cool Batman suits that we did in like BVS. Because sure. Those were cool, classic Batman suits. It's like, yes, that one!
Absolutely.
You know? And, I don't know, what do you think of Flash's suit?
So we have slight disagreement, but not a lot with the Flash suit, I think.
Oh, really?
We'll talk about what I like about it is, I like the overall design of it, but also if you get a really close look, it's held to or pulled together by what looks like electrical wire.
Well, that's what they said it was going to be, right?
Right.
So that's understandable. And the suit design itself actually looks pretty cool. I like the red and black. I like it. But
what, you think it's a clunky helmet?
I think the helmet looks stupid.
Okay.
Now, don't get me wrong. I think the hood looks dumb on the Flash TV show half the time. Sometimes, I don't know. It's so back and forth with the Flash because costume. How do you get that right?
Yeah.
You know?
It's hard to not make it look cartoon, really dorky. Exactly.
But I don't know, man. It makes sense that he's having, like, armor rather than, like, a suit, like, you know, Flash TV.
Right, this Flash looks like he could take a hit a lot better than Grant Gustin's Flash. We're having all, like, the hard armor on.
Sure.
They look like a battle-ready team, I'll say that. Like, everyone looks like they're ready to take on a pretty big threat.
Steppenwolf?
Steppenwolf, perhaps.
I don't know, And I guess the colors are kind of weird on Flash's suit. I know they're like Flash colors, but my biggest problem is Cyborg.
Right. Let's talk about Cyborg, which is the... Because we already knew what Wonder Woman looks like, so Cyborg's like one of the only new people left to get a good glance at.
Right, because we haven't seen a full Cyborg yet, and we saw a small glimpse of Flash and Suicide Squad. So, you're staring into...
I just don't think I cleaned this cup before I put Sunkist in it.
Okay, wonderful.
Yeah.
Cyborg, what do you think?
So we were having a little bit of a debate before we were recording the show where, you know, Tyler doesn't like that. It looks like the only human part of him is like 3/4 of his face. And I was thinking back to what we saw in...
If that. It's like a quarter of his face.
Sure.
Or a half.
I was thinking back to BVS when... I hate how they did this in BVS, by the way. But, oh, you got it right there? Yeah. I do like the almost red lightning.
It's 3/4 of his face.
Okay. Yeah. And everything else is, like, mechanical. Whereas most people that know Cyborg, if you know Cyborg, it's usually, like, a little bit of skin here, mostly machine here, and it kind of goes, it's like a pattern over his body. To me, this design makes more sense than the classic Cyborg design. Because if he's fusing with the Mother Box technology, which we saw happen to him, it doesn't make sense for him to have a lot of exposed areas.
And why would he have, yeah, exactly, exposed skin? He would probably have armor over that.
Exactly. So there might be more than just that part of his face under there, but it's hard to tell.
It looks really skeletal from this, though. But who knows? And I do want to say, other than, like, obviously Aquaman looks really good, Wonder Woman actually looks really good. She looks pretty good.
She does look great. I do like that they added, they actually gave Cyborg like hinges on his leg instead of making them super humanoid. They're trying to make him almost more robotic than human.
Oh, I didn't even notice that.
I've looked at this picture a lot.
Wow. That's the first I'm noticing of that. I spent so much time obsessing over this Transformers looking kind of.
See, if you look at Cyborg for a while...
As a team, they look really good. This is a good picture. They look great as a team.
I like that they put Cyborg in front. Look, when you look at this picture, where do your eyes go?
Cyborg. Boom. Straight to Cyborg.
Which is, I think, for that's sure. Really cool. And as we've said, Aquaman looks great. He's got like a knight's armor, kind of.
I'm most excited for Cyborg in the Flash, to be honest. But Aquaman, I never thought I'd be like this... Aquaman's gonna be cool and he's gonna be a badass and I would never F with him, you know? So
I'm excited to see, because we saw in the trailer that he's resistant to join them. I want to see what it takes to make him join them for this image, and
Batman brings Wonder Woman with him, and he goes, "Wowzers!"
that's good. All right, so moving on from Justice League.
Sure.
Okay, so we have the first official synopsis.
Or what did I say real quick when I first saw that picture?
Oh, 100% unwatchable.
Zero out of ten.
Yeah, literally zero out of ten. Because Flash's bulky helmet and Cyborg is 3/4 of a face.
All right. Anyway.
All right, moving on to the first official synopsis of Logan. Do you have that on there to pull up real quick?
Yeah.
Right. There it is. And most of this you can see from the trailer. Okay. In the near future, a weary Logan cares for an ailing Professor X in a hideout on the Mexican border. Saw that in the trailer. But Logan's attempts to hide from the world and his legacy are upended when a young mutant arrives being pursued by dark forces. So I think the only thing that's kind of new is that he's hiding from his legacy. And from the world.
Hiding from his legacy, what does that mean?
That's what I'm wondering. Like, what is he left behind? What happened to the X-Men? I want to know what happened to all the mutants. Because in the trailer he says there are no more mutants. But he's hiding out from the world.
You think they were straight token in the middle of the night?
Straight token.
Has happened, like,
I don't know.
Two times, three times in this franchise so
But
far.
It's not like there's no more X-Men. There's no more mutants. But this doesn't look like... We've seen a world ran by Sentinels before.
They can't do Sentinels again.
Yeah, this doesn't look like a world taken over by Sentinels, because that was all dark, black, dingy. This is... Like, they almost just died off. It's weird. Like a disease or something.
You think that there might have been, like, some sort of massive disease that attacked...
Planet of the Apes style, kill the mutants disease.
Well, like a zombie... Some sort of virus that wiped out, that only affected humans, mutants, and humans were fine.
I have no idea what happened. I'm just kind of spitballing and speculating here.
Because we're seeing Professor X, who's a stronger mutant, mm-hmm. but he looks like shit.
Yeah.
And then we're seeing Wolverine, who's got the healing factor, and obviously...
It's going down the drain a bit. Losing it.
Yeah. So, I don't know. It has to be... It has to be almost some sort of virus that's killing him. Or something that killed him.
I'm really curious, because we know almost nothing about this movie. I do know a second trailer's right around the corner, though. They're starting to amp up, giving us the synopsis.
It comes out in March!
Picture. We're gonna get
it's
another
like
trailer.
It's like 50 days away when it comes out.
Woo!
If that.
Logan is the next... Does Logan come out before or after King Kong? Because they're both...
I don't know, March. But March is going to be crazy. We
so
get
excited for
Iron
March.
Fist in March, too.
Oh, shit. I didn't even think about that.
We get Iron Fist
we
in
get
March.
We get Iron Fist, Kong, Power Rangers, Ghost in the Shell, Logan. March is going to be a good month.
It's going to be loaded. And we'll come back to Iron Fist. I don't know. I just want something else more out of this Logan thing, because it comes out in March.
Right.
Where's, like, a real trailer? I want more than, like, vague synopsises and, like... I still don't want the movie spoiled for me. I, like, want some sort of wonder about it. Kind of like what they did in the trailers for Suicide Squad, but don't fail me. You know what I mean?
Are they going to use another Johnny Cash song?
What? Johnny Cash song? I don't know. I like Johnny Cash a lot, but what has more impact than that Nine Inch Nails song?
I don't know. Maybe that's why they're holding off doing a trailer. They're like, well, I don't think we could outdo our first trailer.
People keep coming. All right, come up with music ideas. And people are like throwing trash at them. And they're like, no, I don't know. Like, what's going to work?
I don't know. Yeah, so we're excited for Logan. I just took a Logan selfie when I was at the theater earlier today.
Oh, yeah? Do they have a standee there?
It was too big for me to get much else than like his face and claws in, because it's Logan and it goes for like 12 feet.
Right.
But so I just got the O in the background.
But we are very excited.
Hey, we finally have those when we need them. You just call me Blob?
No.
I don't know why. That's what I think of every time. Okay, moving on from Logan. Let's keep the Marvel going. You talked about Iron Fist a little bit. We got our first look at all the offenders.
Offenders.
The offenders. The defenders.
It's called the offenders.
And that's going to be the, what do you call it? The parody version, or the, you know, the triple X version online when you search on Google.
Okay.
The offenders.
Anyway.
The defenders. There's already interracial.
Is this one? Was this one the first look?
Well, that's the Entertainment Weekly cover, and then there's I sent the other one over.
I know there was another one, but which one was it? This is the official first look.
That's
okay.
That's what's inside the magazine.
Okay.
So we get the first look of all of them in a picture together, which
classic is classic Luke Cage.
Yep, we get classic Luke Cage. You got the yellow shirt, Matt Murdock looking like Matt Murdock. Jessica Jones doing really nothing. Honestly, my takeaway from this image is the steel serpent
on
Iron Fist's chest. I love that. That's classic comics. He is wearing green. That's cool. But I was hoping by the time Defenders came around, he was going to have his costume. Maybe he does, and we're not seeing it, though. Because obviously Daredevil's not
in wearing Daredevil his garb. Costume.
Right.
You think Jessica Jones is going to keep that?
Or Jessica Jones doesn't really have a costume, so yeah.
She does have a costume, though. I've seen it. It's just stupid.
Well, it was the Jewel costume when she used to be a superhero, but once she gave that up, she stopped wearing that.
Okay. So you think she's just going to stay that? Luke Cage is going to stay with the yellow...
That bicep, though.
What? Oh, it's so corny. Did you ever finish Luke Cage?
Yeah, of course I did.
Yeah. Duh.
Duh. Did you?
Yeah.
Oh.
I really did. It gets better, but it's... I'm just looking
Here's to Iron Fist. Yeah.
It wasn't bad. It wasn't bad. Like, they're still going strong. Like, it's still a strong franchise. I just thought... I liked Daredevil Season 1 and Jessica Jones Season 1 so much better. Who knows?
Spoiler for... If you have not watched Luke Cage... Give me this for, like, the next 20 seconds.
Sorry to anybody tuning in live in the next 5 seconds.
So, Mike Coulter, who Luke Cage, obviously, recently said in an interview that it was a mistake in his eyes killing Cottonmouth.
It was a huge mistake. He was one of the strongest characters in the entire Marvel TV franchise. And it would have been great to see how he interacted with Fisk or anything like that. There was so much potential for him. There's so much potential.
After they took him out, it just kind of made watching the show a chore for me.
That's exactly what happened. That is exactly what happened. And it's unfortunate because I do think that, like, Diamondback, after you initially see him his first few episodes are very weak and literally unwatchable.
And kind of overacted.
But he definitely does grow as a character, and it definitely he definitely assimilates his role in a way. So... It becomes more strong and more rooted in... It's so disappointing with what you got with Cottonmouth that it's hard to, like, take the rest of it for what it is, because that's always in the back of your head while you watch it. But that being said, and it doesn't... You and Brittany were just talking about how a finale has to be a finale, you know?
Right.
This was such a weak finale. It was like... It was just like, okay, here's sort of the end. I mean, I guess.
Yeah, like
that's what it was like.
Not to hold on these guys for too long, but like the end of, I'm trying to think of Daredevil Season 2, but for sure Daredevil Season 1, the Fisk story and like everything that they're doing came to a close. Like it came to a head, and it's like, there's the season finale. Let's lead on to next season.
Jessica Jones for sure comes to an end, you know?
And Luke Cage is meh.
Yeah, I think, and I definitely feel like Mike Coulter was a lot more, stood out a lot more in his own solo series than he did in Jessica Jones. I feel like their chemistry was weird in Jessica Jones. So I definitely like that he got his own series, but I'm hoping that sort of after Luke Cage Season 1 and Iron Fist Season 1, that they just make a Heroes for Hire show.
I was just going to ask if you would like to see that. Yeah, that's what I want to see too. I'm really excited to see Iron Fist because I want to see the final piece casting-wise, because so far, Mike Coulter is a perfect Luke Cage.
And sometimes his acting falls a little flat, but I think that overall, he is a great pick for Luke Cage.
Yeah, and Charlie Cox originally I didn't think was a great pick, and then after watching the show, I'm like, I like him as Matt Murdock.
Yeah.
Almost as Matt Murdock more than Daredevil, but I do really like him. Kristen Ritter as Jessica Jones is perfect. So Finn Jones is another question mark for me, so I'm waiting to see how he does as Danny Rand.
And we haven't even seen any Danny Rand at all. We've seen a small, like...
couple fight scenes. Yeah. We haven't seen him open his mouth once.
Sure. Who knows? But, I mean, so overall, we have more, a lot more from this and a lot more promise from this than we've gotten from the Arrowverse. And granted, there's one that's restricted to, like, FCC and, like, network TV. Then they can obviously say whatever they want, do whatever they want, show whatever they want. To whatever the extent that the network agrees, you know. But, Defenders.
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 Oh, the point I was trying to say before we even started this, and I said it was going to be the only thing I talked about with this show, is that Sigourney Weaver's the villain, and that's pretty cool.
But we don't remember who the villain is.
Right. I think it's not somebody from the comics, but I could be wrong.
So this image, though, is... it's all four of them. They're... well,
it looks like a bad rap album.
It's Public Enemy. So, well, it's Public Enemies, but it's Public Enemy. And then they scratched out Enemies and wrote Defenders in fucking graffiti.
So clever.
Public Defenders, because Jessica Jones and
Jessica and Matt are both Public Defenders.
Well, no, she's a private eye, and he is an attorney.
Okay.
So, I guess, yeah, public defenders, sort of.
Sort of.
They both take cases for clients.
There you go.
And then we got the Entertainment Weekly cover, which they're always sitting on a vehicle, apparently. This one looks more like a taxi cab. And it just shows a little characterization in their names. Jessica Jones. And then you got Luke Cage, and then Daredevil, and then Iron Fist. So,
can you please reanimate all those with your arms again?
Jessica Jones, okay. Luke Cage, Daredevil, Iron Fist. So, and you'll understand when you see the graphic. Why are we getting something from the Defenders? Well, maybe it's not more, but why are we getting something from the Defenders when we're still have nothing from Iron Fist when it's coming out so soon?
I had an answer and then I didn't.
Do you think they're trying to draw an audience to Iron Fist? That's by hinting at the Defenders?
I think that's as close to an answer as what I had, yeah.
Because Luke Cage did really well. Like, people seem to love it a lot.
Yeah. Well, you know how they want people to... they saw... or they called the first Captain America movie Captain America the First Avenger.
Right.
And I think that's what they're doing with Iron Fist.
Essentially. Like,
the next thing
is... well, how many people would have gone and seen a Chris Evans Captain America movie if they didn't... if everybody didn't know, where obviously, that they were doing an Avengers movie?
Nope, not many.
I mean, I didn't like Captain America before I saw the movie, and then I saw that movie and I was like, damn, that movie was good. So, and then how many people do you think know what Iron Fist is?
This guy.
Literally one person. So, yeah, I think it's smart, though. I think it is.
Give Doctor Strange and Kung Fu, and that's kind of what you got.
But please... And that's another thing, is that... Netflix, their trailers, like, they have, like, their YouTube page, which will put, like, their trailers to, like, the top of what?
Does Series of Unfortunate Events come out today?
Did it?
I think it did.
Did it come out?
I haven't
watched it yet. See, that's another thing, is when you're anticipating something, there's not a whole lot of, like there's trailers, and there was a lot for Series of Unfortunate Events, but what I'm saying is... Iron Fist comes out in March. Where's the hype? How many people know about it? A lot of people know what's coming out. A lot of people are anticipating it. But you could have more people. You could have more hype. You could bring more people to it.
Sure.
There needs to be some advertising, some...
well, I think because push. It's the shows they do a little differently. What I've noticed with Jessica Jones, Daredevil, and Luke Cage is they'll have, like, one little trailer... and then, like, silence for a long time. And, like, the month before is where they just ramp it up. And I think Defenders is just getting some early hype because they've been building up to it for like 3 years.
Well, there we go. We want more. Now I want to know more information about Defenders before I even see Iron Fist.
There you go.
So I guess it's effective. But there you go. We got more out of that topic than...
Fucking... Yes.
All right, so what's the next one?
So now we're going to go back to DC.
Okay.
Because I want to talk about Wonder Woman bracelets. Or, like the freaking Wonder Woman theme song is badass.
It's, yeah, I mean, it's really in your face, but it's good.
I like it. So, we have speculated in the past that Ares, God of War, is somehow going to play into being in the Wonder Woman film. We now have, I would say, 98% confirmation that Ares will definitely appear in the film. And that is because we got a quote, I forgot who from, but somebody involved with the studio, basically saying that if you don't want to know anything about Wonder Woman, and you're avoiding trailers and all that stuff, tune out now for a couple minutes. They're saying that when Chris Pine, Steve Trevor, shows up on the Amazonian island, and by show up, I mean crash lands, is because he had just stolen...
Did he crash land?
Yeah. Into the...
oh, it's in ocean. A plane.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, remember? He crash lands into the water.
And it's been a long time since I've seen the trailer, so he could have washed up on shore from a boat, for all I know.
Okay, well, he lands in the water, and Wonder Woman dives out off a cliff into the water and drags him back to land. But he was getting a scientific formula from the Germans. This is World War One, everybody. And
the Germans.
The Germans, because I incorrectly last time said the Nazis, but it was World War Two, so...
Yeah.
The Germans. Anywho, so he's got that formula, and the formula is for a gas that they want to use to take out... the world, because it's Ares, it's got to be a world conquering event, because that's just the kind of person that he is.
Well, he's literally a god.
Yeah, he is literally a god. And so what happened is Ares wants to take out humanity because humanity was created by Zeus. In this storyline is, one, the person that created Wonder Woman, two, is now dead because Ares rose up against the Amazonians and Zeus and took him out. And so now he wants to destroy Zeus's favorite creation, mankind. So that's where we are at with Ares. And knowing all that, I'm pretty damn sure he's going to be in the film. Probably played by Danny Houston.
Is Danny Houston confirmed? Who even is that?
Danny Houston is in the trailer.
Oh, okay.
But he looks like a German soldier. Or not a soldier, but a general. And my thought is that that's Ares disguising himself as a human.
Okay.
That would make sense to me.
Well, that would be really cool. Now, okay, this just...
Stryker from X-Men Origins.
Right, right.
Okay, sorry.
Right. who... Okay. And bear with me here. They're making a Justice League Dark movie. I don't want to derail this conversation. Because I want to stick to Wonder Woman.
That's okay.
They're making Justice League Dark.
Yes.
It's going to have Constantine in it.
Yes.
Constantine revolves around heaven and hell. Who created the hell and heavens when Greek mythology is fact? right? So who was the true creator?
With comics it seems like everybody exists.
Okay, sure. Was okay. All right.
I feel like you're hurting.
I don't want to get too There's okay.
Okay.
Let's just be excited for Ares.
Let's just be excited for Ares. And not
so that's awesome that we're getting more out of Wonder Woman, which also comes out very soon. Yeah, so
July.
Yeah, so, I mean, it's a little further out than some stuff like Logan and Iron Fist that we've got nothing from, but it's interesting. We really need more. I really want to know what I'm walking into, other than this is a Wonder Woman movie. So Ares, cool. So that's really cool. We're dealing with gods among men.
Absolutely. And Wonder Woman is my number 5 most anticipated film for 2017. So keep giving me news about it. I'm very hopeful that it is good and not only changes people's perception of the DC movie universe, but also female superheroes.
Right. Do you think that they're trying to give us like a little bit at a time because they don't want to push too much on the movie like they did with Batman versus Superman and ruin expectation with it, or ruin, or I, because I don't know, because in Suicide Squad 2 there was so much hype for it and it turned out to be such a disappointment. You think they're trying to keep it like, come see it and you'll be pleasantly surprised, like give you enough draw to make you want to go see it,
possibly,
but and then like I don't know, because I feel like we should have more at this point.
July is a long way out. We've gotten two trailers for Wonder Woman, and usually there's only three trailers for a movie, other than TV
we have
spots.
Two. We have two trailers, or I thought we had like a teaser.
We had the Comic-Con trailer, which is 2 minutes long, and we had the Wonder Woman trailer too, which is like 2.5 minutes long.
But the Comic-Con trailer was a trailer.
Yeah.
Okay. I thought they were at this point, like all movies were doing like a two teaser trailers, and then one trailer, and then another trailer, and then like some other jumbled trailer. Like
usually, the first trailer is considered the teaser trailer, is what I'm saying. Then they have like a second trailer.
Well, like the Guardians of the Galaxy, we have.
They're marketing like crazy, so it's hard to tell.
Two trailers,
right?
But they're both teasers,
right? But the second one is considered like their first. They're doing it weird, okay? I don't know. I don't have explanations. All companies.
All I'm saying is that okay. Regardless of however many amounts of trailers or whatever we have, we don't know a whole lot about this movie because we just found out
Ares is a single other thing. I wanted to know if Ares was going to be in it or not, and that's it. Like, I'm good now. Like, I feel like
Does this make you want to see it more?
Yeah.
Okay.
It does. Because, well...
If you knew more, then that would... make you want to see it less, or make you know more too much about it going into it?
Kind of the second one. Like, I don't think knowing more would make me want to see it less, but I don't want
to. You don't want, like, a doomsday drop?
No.
Okay. And that makes a lot of sense. I'm just saying.
I don't even want to see Ares until the movie.
Okay.
That's where I'm
at. Do you think if the general audience knew that there was going to be, like, a god in this movie, that it would draw them to go see it more?
No, if anyone's going to see this movie, they're seeing it for Wonder Woman, not for a villain. Because Wonder Woman doesn't really have villains that speak out to a lot of people. She doesn't have the Jokers and the...
Right.
I'm trying to think of other villains that people actually care about. But you know what I'm saying.
Yeah, no, I totally get it. Yeah, I'm just saying... All I was saying was there's... I'm sure there's something more that could draw more of an audience, but you're right. People that are going to see this movie are already going to go see it. And, you know, big, strong female lead, big, important role for them to not mess up. So.
Don't fuck it up, DC.
There's.
None of this.
Yeah, I'm failing to say something, but it's like. There's a lot that this movie has to be. And I was just thinking that maybe they can show more of how it's going to be that.
I don't mind seeing a lot more action. I just hope the next trailers are action heavy and some quips. Like, I don't want story. Don't give me any more story. That's where I'm at. But I'm also a huge fan, and I'm filling in a lot of blanks that the general audience won't. So they might need more story.
Okay.
So I kind of understand where you're coming from. Moving on?
Yeah. All right.
Moving on.
Before I stumble over my words more.
To... Star Wars, nothing but Star Wars.
Except for all the stuff we mentioned before.
Yes. So, brief little thing, kind of a big thing, actually. The Vader scene, we're not going to talk about what it consists of, but the Vader scene in Rogue One, the scene that people are talking about, we just found out this morning...
That it was a reshoot.
It was a reshoot. We knew that this movie went through a lot of reshoots, and we're wondering, I wonder which scenes were reshoots, because half the trailer is not in the movie. Well, apparently, the one scene that everybody's talking about was a reshoot. So, does that raise some questions for you?
Not really. I'm wondering, because we heard this about that scene with Darth Vader for a while, right? But then we heard, when did we hear that they were going into reshoots? I guess,
like,
I mean...
three different times.
Yeah, okay. Well, I guess so that scene had to be a reshoot because it said it's a reshoot, but... I mean, movies go into reshoots.
Right. This one, it went to extensive reshoots. They said like the last third of the movie.
What are the scenes that we saw in the trailers of Darth Vader that weren't really in the film? Because I feel...
There was a... There's a scene... This isn't a spoiler because it's in the trailer, but Krennic is talking to Vader. And okay. He's like... He says something about, like, you don't understand the power that we have here. Like, you're talking about the Death Star. Not in the film.
Okay.
He does... It's a different setting, too. It's not the setting we see Krennic confront Vader in Rogue right. One. It's more like... it doesn't have...
So you think Krennic and Vader obviously originally had more interactions?
Yes. I think they had more than just the amount of interactions that they had in the film. And, I mean, there's... A bunch of stuff with Saw Gerrera that we saw in the trailers that wasn't in the film.
There was more Saw Gerrera.
Yeah.
Okay. Is there any talk of, or do you think that there is more of a director's cut coming?
I was just watching Collider Jedi Council, and they talked about, you know, having a rogue cut, you know, or a director's cut for Star Wars.
They better not call it a rogue cut. They're going to call it a rogue cut.
And then there's the scene of... This I actually know what happened to, but Felicity Jones walking at the end of the bridge in the TIE Fighter coming up. Do you remember that in the trailer?
Yeah.
Yeah, did you notice the TIE Fighter was not in the movie?
No, yeah, I saw.
Yeah, it's because...
The movie twice.
The X-Wing was going to come by and shoot that TIE Fighter down, which mimics the X-Wing coming by and shooting the AT-AT earlier. And so they're like, it's a mimic. Cut it up.
Oh.
But anyways, this makes me wonder what... Were you going to do with Darth Vader if that scene was an after-the-fact thought? Because you, so far in the movie, had done almost nothing with him. So I want to know what their end game plan was. Because a lot of this seems like it was after-the-fact.
We heard that like there was going to be like a scene that was like a horror movie with Darth Vader.
Right.
Do you think they had something else like that? Decided to cut it out. You think they had more of like a hunter versus hunted thing, predator versus prey with Darth Vader initially, but sort of kind of like let that go away into their own sort of story.
I had Gareth Edwards, the director, to sit down and ask him a million questions, because I would ask him that. I would ask him so many things. I know that they wouldn't put him down on the beach with everyone on Scarif. You know why?
Because
he hates sand.
Oh, does he? I didn't know that.
Remember Hayden Christensen? I hate sand. It's coarse and rough and it gets everywhere and it's irritating.
Do you remember what I said about like the last time I saw
the prequels?
Yeah.
That is like the joke of the prequels, is hating sand. I was trying to make a joke.
Oh, you were trying. Oh, you were funny. Oh, he's very funny.
Oh, because the weather. It's not nice. It's funny. I hate you. Moving.
What?
What?
I don't have any... I don't have any sense of like what could have been, because that movie ended up being more than enough for me.
Enjoyed it, but I have questions. What Gareth Edwards ultimately wanted prior to reshoots.
Sure. I mean, there are questions, but I think it, like I said, it turned out pretty good. Yeah. So.
It was good. Go see Rogue One if you haven't yet. I hope we spoiled all of it. We didn't. We tried not to.
Right.
We did a pretty good job. Okay, moving on to, where is he? There he is.
Where are you trying to point?
Deadpoolio.
Oh.
I got it.
Deadpool.
Yeah. Deadpool! Talking about Deadpool 2, directed by one of the John Wick directors. No longer Tim Miller. Sad. Teardrop. Colossus and Negasonic Teenage Warhead, who were some of the highlights of the first Deadpool movie.
For sure.
They're returning!
Oh, no way!
The best interpretation of Colossus that we've ever had. By far. I'm glad they actually... It's funny, it took a Deadpool movie to get an X-Men character right. After, like, 7 X-Men films.
Well, yeah, and he was in... Okay, do you think that that's what separates Deadpool from the rest of the franchise? Because there's clearly a different Colossus.
That's part of it, and they actually... I don't know. As goofy as the Deadpool movie is, Tim Miller and company are still true to the characters, whatever characters they use. So I feel like Cable's going to be a great interpretation. Domino's going to be a great interpretation.
But when we heard that rumor that like Ryan Reynolds was going to reprise his role as Deadpool in Logan, and everyone was like, yeah! And I've actually seen things like Ryan Reynolds is trying to convince Hugh Jackman to do one more Wolverine and Deadpool movie.
Sure.
No.
You say no?
No.
I say no Deadpool in a Logan movie. I say yes to Logan in a Deadpool movie.
I say yes to Logan in a Deadpool movie, but get somebody else. Get Carl Urban. Or just have... I don't know.
Oh, and make a joke about how they couldn't afford the other guy.
They should do that. It should be a super expensive actor, but joke how they couldn't... Like, they couldn't... There was not enough fondling they could do to his down unders to make him do it. You know?
I know what you're wondering. Whose balls did I have to fondle to get my very own movie? Well, I'll give you a hint. His name rhymes with Pulverine. He's got a smooth pair of criminals down under.
Yeah.
Good times. Good stuff. So we're excited to see those two come back. And I love the joke about how the studio couldn't afford to bring in more X-Men to the film.
It's like they didn't have any money or something. What did he say? It was something like that.
I don't remember. Something along those lines.
But,
Deadpool's a good time.
Punch. They were good characters.
Yeah, and I like how Negasonic
In the ass?
I like how Negasonic and Deadpool play off of each other. And what does he say? Oh, hello, Ripley from Alien 3. It's just like, shit, you're old. What? Anyways, I think that's...
You're very beautiful. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're good characters. Of course they should come back. And if you're worried that there's going to be...
Oh, like, we did talk about my concern.
Yeah. Well, go ahead.
Okay. I thought you were just going to take that one. Basically, Colossus is kind of your straight man character. Negasonic is your snarky character. And then Deadpool's obviously... You have your straight man, and then you have your Deadpool character. Cable is going to be very much like Colossus. No shit. Straight man character. Domino's going to be in the movie. She's also snarky, smartass. And so my hesitation with having all four of these characters in there is it just feels like a replication of another character. Like, Cable feels like he's going to be a carbon copy of Colossus, and they're in the same movie, and same with Negasonic and Domino.
And my argument was that would probably be comedic.
It could be. It could be repetitious. It could go either way.
Well, it'll be both.
Yes. But, yeah, that's all I have to say about Deadpool. Any other thoughts on Deadpoolio?
No.
All right. Well, then that is all the topics for today.
All right.
Woohoo! Bam!
Oh.
Thanks for joining us on the live stream and on episode 35. Oh, shit,
we were live this whole time?
Fuck it! We'll do it live! So thanks for joining us on here.
And we actually stayed live the whole time. They didn't cut us off or...
Yeah, they didn't cut our budget. So apologies for technical difficulties throughout this. Phone falling off several times. We'll get it figured out
next time. We did do a barrel roll.
But we did.
With the phone.
Yeah. Twice. When we did Suicide Squad, the live stream didn't even last the whole time. So this is good. This means that maybe we can do this more. And it'll be cool to see your guys' comments. And thanks for interacting and all that good stuff. No kickflip today. That's all we got to say about today's topics. We'll see you next week. And, oh, I forgot to mention, I'm going to do a review for it because I just left it out of the podcast. I saw La La Land this morning, so I know it crushed all the Golden Globes and all that stuff. I will talk about it, so look forward to that. Musicals and singing, Emma Stone, Ryan Gosling, all that good stuff. Anyways, may the film be with you, and I'll see you next week.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and keep an eye and an ear out for exciting new content. Be sure to follow us on all the social media sites. Twitter is @TheFansplash. YouTube, just search Fansplash. We've got an open Facebook network, Fansplash Network. Instagram is fan_splash_podcast. SoundCloud.com/Fansplash. You can email us, TheFansplash@gmail.com, and Reddit @r/Fansplash. Title and end credit songs written by Jacob Hall. See you next time.
May the film be with you. Always.
Okay, I don't know.
We're going to have a different setup for... Here, can we...